split from Iron Maiden, and I decided that that was a great opportunity to get my own band together.
I had an advert in Kerrang magazine around about the time that Blaze left Maiden.
I got the phone call while I was in hospital, currently undergoing an operation on my knee, and I attended the audition, and here I am now.
And I got a phone call one night, a very scary phone call from this guy asking me all these intense questions, and I was like, hang on a minute, after 20 minutes, I was like, who are you? Because this is my advert. And he went, well, I'm Blaze, and I've just left Iron Maiden. And I went, oh, shit.
So I sent off my tape, made up a little tape on a 4-track. Set off a little biography with it, a few photos, and a couple of weeks later, I got a phone call from him asking if I wanted to come down for an audition.
Prior to Blaze, I'd done a couple of albums with Andy Sneap producing. In July 1999, he phoned me up to ask me whether I'd like to get involved in the project.
The album tells the story of a man who discovers a new dimension, and that is the 10th dimension. And it's his story of how he discovers that and finds that somebody wants to control it and use it for evil.
Expectations for the 10th Dimension tour are many. We're looking forward as a band to playing to many more people in many more territories.
So we're going to be doing some headline shows in South America and across Europe. We'll have a lot more time this time to put some thought into a decent stage set, give people a bit of value for money and give us something to climb on and run about on.
And the support that we've had and the reaction has just been absolutely incredible.
To actually witness it for yourself, you can't put into words, which is why at times I walked on stage with a video camera. Because I knew that when I went home and I was telling my friends what I actually just witnessed, they just would not believe me.
Listen to that!
We used Andy Sneap as the guy who produced the first.
As far as the recording of the new album, 10th Dimension, is concerned, we had a lot more idea of what we wanted this time round.
What we're doing, basically, is just setting the drums up, getting some drum sounds, because that's like the whole root sound of the album. The core sound is the drums.
What are you reading, John?
Hello, we're here doing photos.
Silver Crin advert.
Yeah, we'll do it in slow motion.
Need to pop to the top of a mountain and dip me out of a stream and flick it about a bit.
You having a bad air day, John?
No.
Okay, the theme of the album is time travel. And in The New Scientist this month is a whole article about time travel. So we're well ahead of the game with the theme of the album being about time travel.
Do you believe in time travel, Nigel?
I believe in endless possibilities.
So would you like to go back and change that shit?
Our website's called planetblaze.com, and I decided on Planet Blaze because I wanted it to be like a planet where you could find out absolutely everything about Blaze the band and Blaze Bailey, me.
If someone had said to me when I was 11 or 12, I could turn on a computer and talk literally directly to my favourite band, I wouldn't have believed them. With Planet Blaze, those interactive things are possible.
Because we're in full control of what is happening, it goes straight onto the website. When we're in the studio, we film ourselves. Within a few days, people know exactly what we're doing, and they don't just read about it, they can actually see it as well.
And also, if you've got access to the internet, then what you can do is check up, see what the band are doing at that time, because we try and send in a video postcard every so often.
Hello, Planet Blaze! This is us working on a computer. We're trying to send you some video footage so you can see what we're doing out here, and of course you'll be on it because you've seen some of the shows. We're in Malmo, Sweden, so...
I said before, there's more energy because we play together live. Well, we had played together live for a year and a half or whatever now.
Here we are in Stockholm. Come and have a look at the venue tonight. The doors are just about to open.
Ooh.
As you can see, it's one of the
stunning
medium-sized venues.
This time around, it was all done here in the studio.
John came up with the idea of doing the artwork as a professor's notebook. So you have two sides to the album. On the one side you have the music, which from a first person perspective tells the whole story of what this guy goes through.
And I got together with Blaze and he loved the idea, and he came up with a few suggestions on quotes that also relate with the story, which again follows from the quotes that are on Silicon Messiah.
Friday, I don't know how many days we've been here, but what's happening now is we're talking about the artwork. Okay? So we start with one idea, then we carry on and we're talking about another idea.
And then, as we got more involved, the booklet, the artwork booklet, started from something like 8 pages. Then it went to 12 pages, and everybody were getting involved, and it sort of got really impressive. And I think it's now something like 28 pages.
But because it tells a story, we more or less worked on all of the ideas at once, and that was really, really confusing. So all of us felt like we were going through a kind of mental breakdown.
I'm moving the interstellar reactions from one universe to the next without... Oh!
It's nothing to do with cabbages, no cabbages, but it is patches.
It gets more confusing as we go along.
Some kind of incredible psychotic evolution while we were actually in the studio making the album, because none of us could remember the titles, because every song relates to every other song. So it's like, well, is this Kill and Destroy? Yeah, oh, that's that one. Oh, is this Speed of Light? No, that's not Speed of Light, that's another one. What was that one? Oh, this. So it was really, really confusing. But it had to be that way because the whole album was a concept. And now when you actually hear the songs run into one another and that you hear them tell the story, all the songs are different and live in their own right. You can understand each song as its own thing, but each one in a small way relates to every other one, and really, really proud of the way that we made that work.